Let's get tropical.
Well, I was driving down the I-5 there and I saw myself a four-pointer. And so I said to myself, Chet, if you just swerve this car just a little bit, you're gonna hit that deer. You're gonna get dinner for 2 weeks. And needless to say, if you were to go outside right now, you'd find yourself a deer strapped to the hood of my car. We secured the bacon, but getting to the point, well, on the drive here, I was thinking to myself, you know, now that I got dinner secured for the next 2 weeks, I should probably get to getting learned. So that's what we're gonna do, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to May Madness number 8. I hope you're strapped in and comfortable, because this one is gonna be a wild ride. Now let us get to the library. We will now go to the library to get lost. I gotta stop doing accents. Anything east of like England, I'm not good at. I gotta work on like east, except for German, I can do like the vile decrepitude. Even that's not that great. Watch a Werner Herzog film. Holy cow. Listen to that dude talk about penguins. It's just enthralling. Absolutely enthralling. Anyway, that's like, actually I'll go run and touch it. Hold on. Back and forth through my mind. Let's get to getting learned, baby. Alright, we're in the math section, I just picked up this book, with Zombie Down, by an author I know and love, Davis Hirsch. Read another one of his books, The Mathematical Experience, Phenomenal Text. So I usually do this just to get myself hyped up, and then we're gonna go on to the mathematical logic book that I've been working through, but I'm not really vibing with it right now, so I might just switch it out for a better text. Cause he's going into the, I won't go into it, and like dual definitions of recursion, not recursion, what do you call it, induction. And I was like, dude, why are you doing this? Probably has some reason. It was just really, really terse. So yeah, we're gonna go to those comfy, loungy chairs to read this puppy. Gonna get absolutely torqued out of our gourd. And then, we'll see what happens. Do something for the vlog, probably. And I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget. Back and forth through my mind behind a cigarette. Actually, you know what? Wanna move to another bank of these comfy chairs? Cause I'm too hot. I'm wearing jeans and it's like 20-something degrees inside. Alright, it's a 5.5. I'm gonna take it out though, because I already have like 8 books out and I can just come back and get it. But I was gonna stay here and read some mathematical logic. Instead though, I was more vibing with Norman Wahlberger's videos on logic. I was really into it at like 7 a.m. this morning. Had a coffee and I was like, I was vibing like a champ, dude. So I might actually go home now and watch some more of those videos, go through my textbook. Because I'm honestly, the textbook I'm reading right now, and it's not very vibes, dude. And oh yeah, luckily enough, this goes right here. And just started to rain, that's ideal. Got my rain jacket, let's go. So I was just watching a video by Norman J. Wahlberger, a guy absolutely goated with the mathematical sauce. Just a phenomenal, I can't recommend the guy enough. All of his videos are just on point, but some of them you watch, and before like 6 months ago, I probably would have watched his video and be utterly confused, but it's kind of up to my level of understanding now. You combine Boolean logic with the idea of, with algebra, Boolean 1-0. It's like the math behind computer circuits and stuff.
Actually, do I have my code book?
I first learned it. I'll go over this book another time. I was 14 and wanted to learn about computers. Picked up this book, turned out to be a godsend, Code by Charles Petzold. If you don't understand computers, read this book first. This is the place to start. Hands down, the place to start. Until about page 200 and something, then it starts getting a little hairy, the control circuit stuff. The control circuitry gets a little complicated. And then if you want to know more computer architecture, I would go for, where did I put that book? Just had, oh, there we go. This book. This book is also unbelievable. I searched around quite a bit. This book is goated with the sauce. Digital Logic and Computer Design by M. Morris Mano. It doesn't get needlessly mathematical. It basically explains from nothing how a computer works. And at the end of it, I almost teared up. I'm not even kidding at this page. I got this book and I always want to understand like what's going on in my computer. Hold on here. It's like seared into my mind, this diagram. I think it was this diagram. Doesn't really matter though, it might not be this diagram, but it put it all together where I was like, oh my goodness, given a pile of transistors, I can now build a computer. And this takes you from literally nothing all the way to there. Hugely off topic, but the mathematics behind this is Boolean logic, and you just kind of tied in Boolean logic with the idea of fields, which is really hype. I'll link the video below, though. It's a phenomenal video. If you've been introduced to, like, algebraic fields and stuff, I wouldn't. I'm barely understanding algebraic fields myself. I just kind of have a concept of what they are, and so we kind of tied it in. It's like, oh, it's like a neat application of why we do fields and stuff. For future reference, if you ever write in textbook, my rule is going to be 7 examples or else we're not generalizing. So if you're making some theory, you gotta give at least 7 examples, and then, if you possibly can, and then, like, give as many possible examples so you give the reader a chance to generalize himself or herself, then give the generalization. But if you just go straight to generalization, it's totally unmotivated and it just sucks. That's like my main beef with math textbooks. It's like, what are we doing, guys? Can we please just like give some, if the student themselves comes up with the generalization, it's so satisfying. If you're reading something, you're like, hey, there's a pattern here. And then the book goes, hey, there's a pattern here. And you're like, oh, sick. It's like, let's go. But a lot of time it's just like, there's a pattern and they give you nothing. Here's this pattern. You're like, well, that sucks. Why are we doing this? And it's just painful. But then it can be exciting if you give the examples first. But they never do, and where is it going? Okay, that's gonna be it. I'm gonna go hang out with Neeraj. And if I don't, if he's busy or something, then this is going to be it. So take it easy. I love ya. Godspeed. Now see you in the next one, which is going to be tomorrow. And that ain't what you want to hear, but that's what I-